Hello, church family. I'm excited to give you a live update on where we are as a church in this process of getting back to live gatherings, and we're almost there, and it's so exciting to be able to plan and to relaunch back to meeting together as a church family. So let me take just a couple of minutes of your time to explain to you what things are going to look like over at least the next few weeks through the month of May. This Sunday, May 10th, is still going to be online, Sunday morning. There will be no Sunday evening service on this coming Sunday, May 10th, but everything else will be online. But starting May 17th, we're going to launch live services again here at the church building. We're excited to do that, but in order to do that, we're going to make some slight modifications. And what that means is we're going to have an 8 o'clock service and a 10:40 service, just like normal, but we're going to limit the number of people in each location for those services. We'll have about 50 people or so in the sanctuary, and when that fills up, we'll send about 50 people or so to the Family Life Center. That's for each service. So hopefully that will accommodate everybody. If you're a part of the 8 o'clock club anyway, you're used to coming to the 8 a.m. service, we would encourage you to keep coming to that service. And if anybody is willing, at least for a while, to shift to that 8 o'clock service, that would be greatly appreciated to accommodate fitting everyone else in the 10:40 slot. All right, so we understand not everybody is going to be ready. Not everybody will be comfortable. Some people just aren't ready, or they have some health issues that prevent them from coming back right now. We understand that. And we want to just validate you in the decision that you make, whatever is best for you. So that being said, also, if you are sick, if you have any symptoms of illness, we would ask you to help us out by just staying home for now. We want to make everyone as safe as possible as we gather again. So as we do come back together, we would encourage you to bring hand sanitizer with you. We'll have some available, but in limited supply. Bring a mask with you. That will be acceptable as well. And remember to social distance. We're going to keep families 6 feet away from other families the best we can here in this place. Restrooms will be available, but we want to really keep that on an emergency basis. So please try to do that before you come. We'll be here for about an hour, and it shouldn't be a long time. There won't be any children's programs. There won't be any Sunday school. There won't be any children's church during this time either. And so we'll have all that part of the building behind the sanctuary to the Family Life Center blocked off. This way it will help us out when we clean. We'll be cleaning before the early service. We'll be cleaning between services. So no worries about that. We'll be as clean as we can. Since we're not able to have Sunday school at this time, what we are offering is for our Sunday school classes to meet online. They can do that via Zoom or maybe some other technology that a Sunday school teacher has. If you would like to use Zoom with your Sunday school class, please contact Pastor Mark, contact myself. We can get you set up. It is not difficult. Don't worry about the technology side of it. We can help you do that. And so we're throughout the month of May, we will not have Sunday evening services, and that will accommodate, hopefully, our Sunday school classes to meet in different time slots throughout the day on Sunday. So please let us know if we can help you set that up. Wednesday services through the rest of May will continue to be online, just like we have been for the last bit. So the only thing that will be live now is our Sunday morning service. Just to let you know, we won't be handing out bulletins or anything like that. We will have offering plates. We won't pass them. They'll be at the door of the sanctuary. They'll be at the door of the Family Life Center. So you can drop in your offering on your way out. And we do want to thank you so much for your faithfulness over the last more than a month in giving generously. So we appreciate that. If you have any questions, anything we haven't answered, please call the church, call one of your pastors. We want you to know, we want you to be informed as you get ready to come back. No questions, no worries or concerns in your mind. We're looking forward to this time. It's going to be exciting to get back together as a church family. And so put that on your calendar, May 17th. That's the big day. We're going to relaunch our live gatherings again. So we look forward to seeing you here. God bless you as you continue to serve Him faithfully.